Let's go to Brendon Hannigan. Brendon Hannigan is a 30-year-old male with high SHBG and low free testosterone. Total testosterone is normal, 700 nanograms per deciliter higher, but SHBG ranges from 50 to 80 nanomoles per liter. As a result, free testosterone sits at the bottom of the range and sometimes below it. Symptoms of poor testosterone status, sexual dysfunction, low libido, trouble building muscle mass without gaining a lot of fat, low mood and motivation. Background, this is a long question. Background, hypothyroidism that's currently well managed, treat T4 and T3. Okay. No major weight issues, no sign of metabolic dysfunction or liver problems. Very low progesterone and high estrogen due to, another case of high estrogen, and then due to progesterone, very low progesterone and high estrogen to progesterone ratio, but absolute estradiol levels are below range. Okay, not another case of that then. Okay. Normal prolactin, DHEA, LH, FSH, etc. Very low blood lipids, TC, total cholesterol around 100 to 140, pretty low.
Wow.
Things that didn't work, over-the-counter supplements to lower SHBG and increase free T, more on zinc, various herbs like tomcat, allie, etc., and even a course of sermorelin, an injectable GH secretag, raising total cholesterol to 160 to 170 through cholesterol supplementation. Looking for ideas, what am I missing?
I have no idea. Unfortunately, SHBG is like the bane of my existence. I have no idea how to get SHBG down once it's up. And boy, I sure talk to practitioners about this all the time to figure that out. I would agree that supplements that for SHBG, it's very hit or miss. Tomcat being one of them, DHEA being the other. There's two other ones. Nettles, stinging nettles. Oh, and Avena, oats. There's like very mild, very weak research about lowering SHBG with nettles and then with Avena. Again, it's like hit or miss. So how to get that SHBG down? Well, also remember SHBG binds estrogen as well, although he said his estrogen's low.
His actually total low, estradiol, absolute estradiol is low.
So it's not, his SHBG is not going up because of a low absolute estradiol. And low progesterone gives men the same symptoms as low testosterone. I don't actually worry that much about progesterone because the other things improve. Generally, progesterone improves as well. Generally, yeah.
So I'm curious how an increase in body fat might affect this because.
Did he say?
No, he said he had no weight problems. He said no major weight issues, no sign of metabolic dysfunction or liver problems.
Okay.
So I don't know. Like it seems to me logically that a high SHBG is a bad thing, and that seems supported by his symptoms. But if you look at the literature, high SHBG seems like SHBG goes down with an increase in liver fat
and insulin.
And it seems like a high SHBG is correlated with a lower disease risk for a variety of things. And so I think sometimes it might be counterintuitive, but something like maybe you need to weigh a little bit more sometimes is an issue there. Even though that's not a good answer if the person is not underweight, but
I've heard from some other, I'm not an expert in this at all, but I have heard from some other practitioners. Mycotoxin will raise SHBG. Mycotoxin does. And what was the other one that does? But I have not done any of the research into that. I've just had a few mycotoxin experts say, see it all the time. When we address their mycotoxin, their SHBG goes back to normal. I'm like, well, that would make sense, right? All your binding globulins are going to go up. To bind and protect or try to protect. So you may, Brendon, want to look into other things, viruses, Epstein-Barr, cytomegalovirus, you know, mycotoxin, just things like that. Run some inflammatory markers, see what's up, and just see if you're missing. You're looking at the hormones, but maybe you've run a lot of great stuff, but maybe it's just the next layer down in the onion.
Yeah, I think it's worth noting that his cholesterol still isn't very high.
That's not good. 100 to 140?
He got it. So he says he used cholesterol supplementation to get it up to 160 to 170.
I wonder if that's familial. Like, you know, does everyone in his family have low cholesterol, or is it just him?
Yeah, Brendon, if you're able to comment on that, that would be an interesting question to answer, whether your family members have those issues or have the cholesterol issues specifically. I mean, so my thought is, and you know, when I was a vegan, my cholesterol was 106, my total cholesterol. But I was also like borderline psychotic when I was a vegan. And so, I don't think it was a good thing, but my, even on a high animal fat diet, my cholesterol is around 160 or so. In fact, although it might be higher now, I haven't checked it in a while.
Oh, Brendon answered.
Oh,
Dad and Grandpa have low total cholesterol too, but not as extreme.
Yeah. So, I mean, I don't think you should completely exclude that you might want to raise your cholesterol higher than that. I mean, I know 160 and 170 would be looked at as really, really good from a, you know, from a cardiovascular person's perspective. Like, your cardiologist isn't going to tell you you need it higher, but you know, cholesterol is a precursor to the sex hormones and is going to be a factor in your body's perception of how much abundance you have. And the fact that you needed cholesterol supplements to bring it up to 160 to 170 makes me think that the general state of cholesterol in your body is very, very low by default and is still pretty low. And I don't know, like, what 170 should be okay, but I think given the specific problems that you're looking at, pushing it up to 200 and seeing if you feel any better should be like one of the tools in the kit, is my thought.
It's interesting that some of his hormones are low and some are high. Like, his total testosterone's high, or in range, I apologize, yeah, in range. So he can make testosterone, right? He has the testicular ability to pull in cholesterol and make it, but his progesterone and estrogen aren't absolutely high. So those two are low, yeah, but testosterone's, yeah, but okay. Now, his free is low, but we know that's bound up, so...
Well, we don't know what the cholesterol content of his liver is, but the liver lipids, I mean, obviously you don't want fatty liver, but there might be a threshold where, like, the cholesterol content in the liver and the triglyceride content in the liver are influencing the SHBG expression. Mm-hmm. So my thought is, it's clearly not like the limiting precursor to the production of sex hormones, but it might be the thing. It's just like, no one's going to give him a liver biopsy to figure that out, right? But it's a reasonable thought that it might be influencing the SHBG expression. I mean, neither of us have good answers, but there's some good stuff. So, all right, thanks, Brendon.